Okay, Coach Schoeff, what's it been like to take over the program in your first year so far?
It's been pretty exciting. We've had a lot of getting to know one another. We've had an opportunity here to spend some time for the last 2 weeks. Kind of testing out a new offense and a new defense. Me getting an opportunity to kind of learn on the fly about coaching. This will be my first head coaching job. It's been a great experience for me. These guys have really been receptive to our coaching points and philosophies that we've tried to install as a staff here. And I think that these guys have really bought into what we're trying to preach, and hopefully here before too long we'll really start to see the fruits of our labors.
Okay. How good can Brady Boots be as a senior quarterback this year?
Brady could be a very good senior quarterback for us as long as he doesn't try to do too much. This is a little bit different offense in terms of what's been asked of him in the past. We're going to expect him to stay in the pocket a little bit longer, maybe dissect some defense, use a little bit more of the mental side of the quarterback position than maybe the physical side. We're not going to ask a lot of deep threat throws from him too often. We'll still have that ability with some of our offensive sets. And the other side of it is that we're going to expect him to know a lot more various types of offensive plays with some different schemes involved with those. So he could be very good as long as he holds himself accountable to really knowing those things and really picking them up quickly.
How much of a dual threat can Austin Bauer be running and catching the ball?
Austin would be a pretty good dual threat for us. We haven't repped him a whole lot of running back simply because we've had the emergence of two seniors, Dylan Belcher and Cam Clark, that have really stepped up to the plate in this two-back West Coast style offense and have really shown an ability to run the ball between the tackles well. Austin would provide us an opportunity to kind of stretch the perimeter a little bit, kind of test some people on the outside. He has that ability, but we haven't had to ask that of him yet.
Okay. Defensively, you guys lost a lot of seniors to graduation, so what's that side of the ball look like?
Defensive side of the ball, I've been pleasantly surprised. We've had a lot of guys that have really taken to this new defense. You know, we're changing schemes up a little bit, running a 4-3 instead of the 3-4 that they're used to. And our guys have really taken to it, really kind of embraced that more physicality that it demands with this scheme, I should say. We've seen a lot of guys willing to step up and fill in those gaps for those seniors that we're going to miss, obviously, but we feel that we also have guys that are that are very capable of stepping in and filling in admirably for those seniors.
Finally, what are your overall hopes and goals for the team this season?
Well, you know, obviously everybody says it and it sounds very cliche, but we expect to be playing in Lucas Oil on September 24th. I feel like if we didn't have that goal and we didn't set those expectations that high, then, we're really wasting our time and we're really not going to, to really reach our potential. I always follow that old saying, if you shoot for the moon, or if you shoot for the stars, sometimes you hit the moon. And in that case, we're aiming to play in Lucas Oil on September 24th. If that doesn't happen, our secondary goals are to at least win the sectional and obviously challenge, some of the powers that be in our conference for a conference title.